Canva has some amazing preset frames that you can use in your designs, literally hundreds of them. But did you know you could also create your own custom Canva frames? You can create frames out of shapes, words, even your brand logo. In a previous video, I shared how to create your own custom frames using Canva and a free app called Figma. For part two of my Canva frame series, I want to share a different method using another free app called Photopea. My name is Kat. This is Canva Catter Day. Let's get to it. The first step in creating your own frames is to find a shape. So let's go do a search for a palm tree. That's what I was working with earlier. And I will click on graphics. You'll notice you have a bunch of different options here. You want to make sure you're picking a graphic that is a solid color. Any graphic image that has multiple colors to it will not work when it comes to creating your own frames. It has to be a solid color. So I'm just going to narrow down my choices to one solid color. It's going to make it a little bit easier for me to find what I need. And I will just pick one and let's make this a little bit larger. So there we go. There is the image that I would like to turn into a frame. Next, you'll need to download this. So you're going to click on share and you click download. By default, Canva will always suggest a PNG file for images. In order to turn this into a frame, we have to make this an SVG file, a scalable vector graphic file. So click where it says file type and then go to SVG and also click where it says transparent background. If there's a background to this image, it will not work as a frame. It has to be transparent so that the only thing showing is that specific image. And then you will download this to your device. This is a Canva Pro feature, being able to download as SVG and download as transparent. So if you would like to try Canva Pro, I put a link in the description for a 30-day free trial. You'll click download and it will download to your device. And then we're going to go over to Photopea. Here we are. This is photopea.com. This works very similar to, say, Photoshop and Illustrator, allowing you to manipulate graphics. And it is a free service. So next, we're just going to grab that SVG image. Let me go get it from my downloads. And I'm going to just drag it right on top of Photopea. There's my image right here. In order to turn this into a frame, I need to do one other step. I need to bring in a placeholder image. That's exactly what Canva does when you're working with frames. It uses the images that are there as placeholders. And that way, when you drag an image inside, it takes on that shape. That's what a Canva frame does. Programs might call this a clipping mask, an image container. Canva calls it a frame. So for us to turn this into a frame, we need to make sure that we have another image to use as a placeholder. So let me go grab that. You're going to click on File and then click where it says Opened and Place. Next, you're going to click any placeholder image. It can be a PNG, a JPEG, a photo, whatever that happens to be. It doesn't really matter as long as it's an image file. And you're going to click it and say Open. It's going to import into Photopea. Now, it placed this placeholder image at the bottom of my layers. In order for this to work, it has to be the top layer. So simply drag it to the top, just like that. So now I have my placeholder image, and then there is my palm tree layer image. On the placeholder image, you will now right-click on that layer panel, and you have the option to select a clipping mask. That's what's going to mask this to make it look like that shape. You can also go up here into the top menu bar, click on layer, and select clipping mask. That way, either method will work. So you're just going to click on clipping mask. And now that image was placed inside of that palm tree shape. Next, we just simply download this and bring it back into Canva. Click on File. Click on Save as PSD. That's the format it's going to save so we can bring it into Canva. Save as PSD, and then we're going to go back into Canva. and I'm going to add a new page, and I'm going to drag that PSD file right into Canva. Canva is going to place it into my regular design folder. Here's that image. And then once we add this, we can use this as our frame. So I will click this image right here. That's our PSD. You can see it still has the placeholder image attached. We need to get rid of that. So click on the placeholder itself, the frame itself, and then click this little trash can. And you have an option to delete the image or delete the frame. You want to delete the image. So just click delete image. And you are left with just the brand new frame. Next, you're just going to find any image or video and place it inside. So let's go find something to put inside. Let's grab a photo. How about this one? Drag and drop it right on top of that frame, and it now takes on that shape. You've just created a Canva frame. If you don't like the position of the image that's inside, you can just double click and you can move it over. There's your Canva frame. This also works with text, so you can create text files. Let's go do another shape real quick. So how about we do a cat this time? Graphics. Once again, you have to make sure it's solid colors only. So let me just narrow down my searches and we'll do this one. Here's a cat. Make it a little bigger. Again, we need to download as an SVG file. So click share, click download, SVG, transparent, and download. And then one more time, back to Photopea. I'm just going to reload this page here and it will empty everything out for me. There we go. We have a brand new Photopea file. And I'm going to grab that cat image right there. There's my cat. Once again, I need to put the placeholder image. So I'm going to click on File, Open and Place, grab that placeholder image. This time it did place it on top, which is fine. And then you'll just right click on the layer, click Clipping Mask, and there's our shape. And then we just download this again as PSD. And back to Canva we go. Let me add a new page and I will bring that in. PSD. Go to my designs. And then our frame will be the shape of a cat. Add that to our design. Once again, remove that placeholder image. Just click on the image, click the little trash can, click delete image, and there is your cat. And then you can go ahead and place any other type of image, like maybe that one. There you go. There's that cat. Just like that. What about a logo? Yes, you can also do this with a logo file. So let's do that. I'm going to add a new page and I will add my logo. There's my logo. Remember I said that the image has to be a solid color. My logo is currently two colors. So I need to change this so that it's all one color. Let me just change that. And now I'm ready to download this as my SVG file. Share, download, SVG. And then one more time back into Photopea. Let me reload my page. And let's bring in that image file, SVG. Here we go. Now you'll notice this time I have a bunch of layers, and that's because my logo has multiple parts. It has a whole bunch of different letters. When you're working with anything that's an SVG image that has multiple parts to it, Photopea is going to separate every one of those into a separate layer. You have to make sure that when it does this, you combine these layers. If you don't, what'll happen is that when you bring that placeholder image into Photopea, it will only mask the very top layer and it won't really work for your frame. So you have to combine all these layers together. To do that, you're just going to click one time on the top layer, scroll to the bottom, hold your shift key, click the bottom layer so that they are all highlighted, and then right click and just click where it says merge layers. That makes everything into one layer, and now the frame will work as it's supposed to. So once again, we're going to click where it says File, Open and Place. We're going to add that placeholder image. There's our image. It's on the bottom. We need to bring it to the top. So let's just drag it to the top. And then once again, right click on the layer and clipping mask. There's our image, and we download it so we can put it back into Canva. Click File, Save as PSD, and back to Canva we go. And let me make a new page. And let's bring that file into Canva. PSD, oops, 1 second. PSD, and drag and drop. Well, I have to be in the right folder. There we go. And we'll add this one more time. And just like before, we're just going to simply delete the placeholder image, and then we can use whatever we want inside. Here we go. Click on it. Click the trash can. Detach the image and get rid of it. And there is our frame. I can even add a color to this if I want. You can add images, videos, or colors into any Canva frame. So maybe I want to do something like that. You can add a fun little gradient to your logo if you want to, and then you can go ahead and manipulate those colors around if you want, or you can just stick with images and drag and drop images in there. But basically, sky is the limit when it comes to creating these Canva frames. You can make any shape, any set of words, or even your brand logo and turn it into your own custom Canva frames. If this was helpful, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you can see more videos like this in the future. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.